Hello everyone, myself Tejasvini KS. I am from MIT College. I am going to explain a topic about evaluation of postfix. First, I am taking an expression 4, 5, star, 3, plus. It is a postfix expression because first we have operand, then operator. So it is a postfix expression here also. Operand, operator. It is a postfix expression. First, it will step 1. First, it will read the 4 and it will be stored in stack. Then here t is equal to 0. Then it will read the 5 and it will be stored in stack. Here t is incremented, t is equal to 1. Then it will read the star operator. When operator will read, we have to pop the top of the stack. Here the top of the stack is 5 and 4. The 5 it will be pop and it will be stored in n, and 4 it will be pop and it will be stored in m, and we have to perform the operation. Like here we have the operation like star, so 5 star 4, 5 4s are 20. Then again it will be pushed into the stack. Here t is decremented and t is equal to 0. Then star is over, then it will be read the 3, then it will be again pushed into the stack. Then it will again read the plus. So operator, when we get the operator, it should be pop. It should be pop the top of the stack. Here the pop of the stack is 3 and 20. First 3 it will be pop and it will be stored in n, and then 20 it will be pop and it will be stored in m, and it perform the operation. Here the operation is a plus, so 20 plus 3 is equal to 23, and it will be pushed into the stack. The result is 23. Now I am going to explain with programming. First I will write the program. Ash include IO stream is header file. Then ash include cs string. Here it is a string header file. Then I'm declaring array of characters, array of 5. Storing like 4 character. I'm storing as a character 4, 5, then star, then 3. Plus. Then I'm creating a class called postfix. Then public, it's access specifier. Declaring int m comma n comma t s of 5. It is a stack. Then again public postfix. It is a default constructor because I have to assign a minus 1 to. Then default construction. Then I'm writing a push function in element. Then s of t has to be incremented, so ct plus plus is equal to element. Then pop function in pop. Return s of t minus minus. Then evolve function int evolve int m comma int n comma char f. and I'm writing a switch function, switch off f. And I'm writing a case, if it is star, then I have to perform m star n, then break. Case, if it is addition plus symbol, I have to perform addition m plus n, then break. If it is a minus, I have to perform m minus n, subtraction, break. If it is division, have to perform m divided by n. Break. And I'm writing a display function. Void display. See out result, result of two operand is stack of 0. Then I have to write a main function, void main, I'm creating an object postfix p, then I'm declaring like int n is equal to str length. I'm taking a length of a, it will be assigned to n. Then for function, for I is equal to 0, I should be less than n and I plus plus. Then if function, if a of i is greater than 0, ampersand a of i should be less than 9. If it is both true, then p dot push a of i should be minus with the 0. We have storing like it is a character, so we have to convert to int, so minus 0. Else int m is equal to p dot pop int n is equal to p dot pop, then int result is equal to p dot eval m comma n comma a of i, then p dot push result, then display function p dot display. Program is over and I will tell how it is work. It starts from the main function. program is over, then I'm going to explain how it is works. First, it will start from main function. Postfix p, I'm creating an object p for class postfix. Here the class name is a postfix, so int n is equal to string length of a. It will assign the length of, it will be n, length to n. Then I'm initializing int I is equal to 0, I is less than n. Then if it is, I is less than, if it is true, then it will check for a of I, it should be greater than 0, and a of I is less than n. You can see that a of 0, it should be greater than 0 and should be less than n, so it is true. So it will be comes to the push part. Here p dot push a of I. A of I means it is a 4. 4 minus 0. It will be, I'm storing an expression character, so we have to convert into int. So it is minus with the 0. Then it will read the phi, expression phi. Then it is also be greater than 0 and it will be less than 9. Then it will be pushed to the stack. Then it's again incremented. Then it will be read star operator. It is a star, so it will become, it will be comes to else part. So when the operator comes, it will be pop the top of the stack. Top of the stack is 5 and 4. So it will be assigned to m and n. And the alpha is star, then it will be go to the evolve function and perform the operation. Here the operator is star, it will perform the multiplication, then the result will push to the stack. Then again it will read the operator 3, then it will push to the stack, then operator we need to pop the top of the stack. And it will pop and perform the operation in evolve function, and the result, it will be pushed to the stack. Then I will tell how it is will be converted to character to int. Here the ASCII value of 4 is 52 and ASCII value of 5 is 53. First ASCII value of 4 is 52. First A of 5 is 4. 4 minus 0. The value of ASCII of both ASCII value, it will be get subtracted. 4 ASCII value, it is 52. 0 ASCII value is 48. Then we'll get a result 4. We'll get 4. Then it will be stored in A of I. Then here 5 minus 0, ASCII value of 5 is 53, ASCII value of 48, ASCII value of 0 is 48. Then it's subtracted and it will store the result 5 only. Next, here same 3 minus 0, ASCII value of 3 is 51, and 0 means ASCII value of 0 is 48, then we'll get 3. It will perform the display function and displaying s of 0. Here s of 0. S of 0, it is a 23. It will print 23. Thank you.